Nama saya Nanda, saya mahasiswa, nama baptis saya Catherine. Sampai sekarang, ayah saya Islam, ibu saya Katolik. Selama ini saya menganut surat Al-Kafirun, lakum tinu kum waliyati, untukmu agamamu, untukku agamaku.
Cukup, sebentar. My name is Nanda, and I was Christian, I am student, my father Muslim, and my mother Catholic, and I believe and I practice the surah Al-Kafirun. Teruskan.
Hal ini karena berdasarkan Al-Baqarah ayat 62. Tapi ternyata ada ayat lain yang mengatakan bahwa orang-orang Nasrani dan Yahudi akan masuk neraka. Mengapa ayat yang lain ini kontradiksi dengan Al-Baqarah ayat 62 itu? Lalu siapa?
Cukup. But then that is the verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, verse 22, which says that, verse 62, and there's also that says Christian, Jews, they are not Muslim, they will be in the hell.
Mengapa ayat yang mengatakan bahwa orang Nasrani dan Yahudi akan masuk neraka itu kontradiksi dengan Al-Baqarah ayat 62?
And this that the expression that said that Christian and Jews that they will enter the hell, it contradicts with Al-Baqarah 62. Why?
Lalu siapa yang dimaksud dalam Al-Baqarah 62 itu?
And who is then in the Surah Al-Baqarah in 62?
If I understood the question correctly, that the Quran says that the Jews and Christians will be in hell, but Surah Baqarah chapter 2 verse number 62 says that all those who believe in Allah and have faith, whether you are a Christian or a Jew or a Sabian, you will go to Jannah. So these two verses are contradicting. Before I answer this question, I find it very common in Indonesia that Muslims are marrying non-Muslims and they do it so freely. And while traveling in this few days, I realized that Muslim parents willingly give their daughters to marry a non-Muslim. If a Muslim parents give their daughters in marriage to a non-Muslim, most probably even you will be held responsible. Why do the Muslim parents of Indonesia give their daughters and their sons in marriage to non-Muslims? How are you doing it? Allah clearly states in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 221, that do not marry mushrika until she believes. A believing woman is far better than a mushrika, even if she allows you. That means you do not marry a mushrik girl until she believes. A believing woman, even if she's a slave woman, even if she's a servant, she is far better than a Muslima, even if she allows you. She may be the queen of England. She may be the most beautiful woman in the world. But if she's a non-Muslim, a Muslim woman who is a slave woman is far superior. Why don't the Muslims of Indonesia know that? The verse continues, do not marry a mushrik, do not marry an unbelieving man until he believes. A believing man, a slave man, a servant who is a poor man is far superior than a non-Muslim. Even if he allows you, he may be the most handsome man in the world. He may be the king of the world. But a man who has belief, faith is far superior. I think the Indonesian parents don't read the Quran with understanding. In my country, India, if the children of a Muslim parent marry a non-Muslim, 99% they'll be thrown out of the family. Here, the parent is very happy. My daughter is marrying a Christian. My daughter is marrying a Hindu. My son is marrying a... Hindu lady and he wants to become Hindu and they laugh. What's happened to the Muslims of Indonesia? I want all the universities in Indonesia, in the Islamic studies, to make it a point that do not marry non-Muslim. I'm shocked. When we go to a minority Muslim country, they excommunicate the person. The parents disown her. Here, make it very clear that if you have an option between marrying a non-Muslim who may be the king of the world, who may be the most handsome man, who may be the most beautiful, who may be Richard Gere, anyone. He may be Bill Gates. But a Muslim man who's a servant, who may be the most ugliest man in the world, he is far superior because he has iman. If you have iman, you will go to Jannah. I want to tell the Muslim men, do not marry non-Muslim women. She may be the most beautiful woman in the world, not Indonesia. She may be the most wealthiest woman in the world. She may be a queen. But if you have a mu'mina, a believing woman, who may be the most ugliest woman in the world, who may be a slave woman, she is far superior because she will take you to Jannah. She is your muhsana. The Quran says your wife is a muhsana. Muhsana means fortress against the devil. If you marry a non-Muslim, they are a fortress of the devil, not against the devil. The sister is asking a question. That isn't the contradiction in the Quran. When Quran says in various places, for example, Quran says in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 72, لَقَدْ كَفْرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهُ إِسَ ابْنُ مَرِيمَ. They are doing kuf, those who say that Jesus is son of Allah. That means the Quran says that the Christian and the Jews, they are kafir, they are mushrik, don't marry them. Here, in Surah Baqarah chapter 2, verse number 62, it says that as to those who believe in Allah and who believe in His revelation, whether they're Christian, whether they're Sabian, whether they're Jews, they will get the reward. This verse, sister, in context says, talking about when people come to the Prophet. If you read the tafsir of Ibn Kathir, it says that when the people came to the Prophet, those who were Christian, those who were Jews, those who were Sabian, that we did so many sins in the past. Can we yet go to Jannah? Then this verse was revealed. Irrespective whether you're a Jew or a Christian, if you believe in one Allah and if you believe in His commandment, inshallah, you'll go to Jannah. That means these people accepted Islam. Nowhere does the Quran say that if you remain on Christianity, you'll go to Jannah. If you remain as a Jew, you'll go to Jannah. It's clear cut. It's your misunderstanding. The verse of Surah Baqarah chapter 2, verse number 62, is talking about those people who were in the past Christians and Jews and Sabians, and now if they accept Islam, Allah says, if you accept Islam, you will go to Jannah. Hope that answers the question.